Hey everyone, and welcome to the 5th episode of my Pokemath series, where I'll be making short videos on some of the maths behind Pokemon game mechanics. In this episode, we'll be dealing with stat modifications in Generation 1 and the badge boost glitch. Stats. Huh. What are they good for? Quite a lot, actually. Attack helps you inflict more damage with your physical moves, defense helps you resist more damage from physical moves, and special acts as both offensive and defensive for special moves. Check out episode 1 of Pokemaths for a more in-depth look at how these stats factor into the damage equation and the physical special split. Speed decides who goes first in a battle, which can sometimes be the difference between a win and a loss. Accuracy and evasion are hidden stats which we've covered in episode 3, but basically they can be the difference between winning a battle or throwing your Game Boy in the bin. The user and opponent have many options to modify these stats in battles. Stats are increased and decreased by stages, and all follow the same modification process. To show these stat changes in real time, I'll be making use of Gamehook, which allows us to read the game's memory. So here we can see my Mewtwo has an attack of 125. If the opponent growls us, our attack stage will go down to -1, and our new attack stat will be 66 over 100 multiplied by our unmodified attack, which is 125 times 0.66, which is 82.5, or 82 as we round down. If we then use Swords Dance, our attack stage will increase by 2, going up to +1, giving us an attack stat of 125 times 1.5, which is 187. Then another growl from Eevee brings our attack stage back down to 0, and Mewtwo is back to his original 125 attack stat. And the same stages and modifications are used for defense, special, and speed. If a Pokemon's stat stage gets to -6, it will be unable to be lowered further. If a Pokemon's stat stage gets to +6, it will be unable to be raised further. These moves affect stats by one stage, and these by two stages. Some of these are attacking moves, where the stat effects are a secondary effect that has a certain chance to happen. For example, Psychic has a 33.2% chance to lower the opponent's special stat by one stage. Also, the X items, X Attack, Defense, Speed, Special, all increase their respective stats by one stage. Using X Defend is the same as using Harden once. Any stat stage changes only last for the duration of a battle, or until the Pokemon is switched for another. So if you've been growled 6 times, just switch out to another Pokemon then switch back, and you'll be back to the original unmodified stat value. Stats can be changed permanently in the following ways. Level ups. When your Pokemon gains a level, you can see its stats increase by various amounts. I'll go into more detail about how these amounts are calculated in the next video. Vitamins. Vitamins around the map and in Celadon Shopping Center can permanently boost certain stats. This will also be covered in the next video. And finally, badge boosts. Dun dun dun! It's the moment you've all been waiting for. The glorious bit of alliteration that finds itself in every Gen 1 Pokemon video without fail. Every odd badge grants you a permanent 12.5% boost to a certain stat. Brock, the defensive rock gym leader with massive defense Pokemon who enjoy using Defense Curl, he of course gives us the attack badge boost. Surge, the lightning fast gym leader with speedy electric types who outspeed your Pokemon and he occasionally uses an X speed in battle. Yep, he gives us a defense boost. And Koga is actually speed, and Blaine is special. So we can see here before I fight Brock using my same Mewtwo from before, my attack is 125. And then afterwards in my next fight, I haven't leveled up and my attack is now 125 times 1.125. which is 140, due to the attack badge boost. But if I open my Pokemon stats within the game, it seems like the badge boost hasn't been applied, but I can see it in Gamehook when I'm in a battle. Well, it turns out the badge boosts are applied when you first enter a battle, transforming your unmodified stats to your badge boosted stats. And then at the end of the battle, you lose the badge boosts again. The stat modifications still take place on that unmodified, unbadge boosted value we used before, but then after the modification has taken place, we apply the badge boost to the affected stat. And so before Brock, our possible attack stat values for this Mewtwo were from 31 to 500. But now we have the attack badge boost, our potential in-battle attack stat values are from 34 to 562. If our Mewtwo raised its attack one stage, the game would take the unmodified, unbadge boosted attack stat of 125, modify it to stage 1, which would be 187, and then apply the badge boost, giving Mewtwo an attack stat of 210. Time for another example. I have all 8 badges, which means I'm getting badge boosted for all 4 of my visible stats. Out of battle, my Kakuna has 61 defense, which means in battle he should have 61 times 1.125, which is 68. Yep, that looks right. We take Aaliyah, which brings our defense down to the minus 1 stage, giving us an in-battle defense stat of 61 times 66 over 100, which is 40. We then apply the badge boost, which gives us 45. Kakuna uses Harden, bringing our defense stat back up to stage 0, which gives us 61 times 1.125, which is 68 again. Everything's working great, right? Oh wait, no, you're right. The attack stat increased when we were hit by the Leah, and then again when we used Harden. And come to think of it, the speed and special stats also increased. And there we have it. The single biggest mistake that Gen 1 has to offer, which has made these games unique and changed the world of solo Gen 1 Pokemon challenges forever upon its discovery. This is the badge boost glitch. Every time our Pokemon's stats get modified, when the badge boosts are applied at the end of the calculation, they mistakenly also get applied to every other stat that you have badges for. So if I have all badges and use Harden, I can see my defense stat has increased to stage 1, but every other stat I have badges for also got oomphed up by 12.5%. Thus leading to Gen 1 YouTubers saying mad things like, I'm gonna set up a few Hardens until I start to outspeed. And the badge boost is not just limited to when our stats increase, it also takes place when our stats are decreased. Unlike with regular stat modifications that have a limit to plus 6 stages or minus 6 stages, there's no limit to the badge boosts. So long as your stats are changing, the badges are boosting.
Boost my bottom!
I'm boosting!
Boost my bottom!
I'm boosting!
So we can actually reach the cap of 999 for a stat, just by hardening every time this Onyx uses Leer. Thanks for the boosts, now get wrecked! Aw man, Kakuna, you suck. These badge boosts seem overpowered. Do they at least have a weakness? Yes, they do. Upon level up, we correctly calculate our stats again, taking into account any changes in our unmodified stats that the level up gave us, and then freshly applying our current stage modifiers and a single intentional badge boost. And in doing so, we lose all our extra badge boosts. This is a frequent concern in Gen 1 solo runs, as you'll often see people using rare candies before big battles, making it less likely to level up in the middle of them, and that way they can keep hold of those sweet sweet boosts. If the move Haze is used, all of our stats get modified down to their 0 stage values, without any badge boosts, not even the ones we're supposed to get after entering the battle. If the stat that's been boosted gets modified by a move, when a stat is directly modified we go back to our stages table, which is multiplied against the unmodified stat value, and then gets one legitimate badge boost. So if I've managed to get Kakuna's attack to 347 through badge boost manipulation, by having my defense stat increased and decreased over and over again, if I decide to get greedy and boost that attack further using Sword Stance, it doesn't stack, and instead it gets calculated correctly as 45 times 2, which is 90, times the single badge boost, giving it 101. So by purposely increasing our attack, we've actually ended up with lower attack than we got without touching it. If you have double team and growth, and you want a massive special stat, it'd make more sense to do the growths first, getting to plus 6 special stage, and then doing 6 double teams, getting 6 extra 12.5% badge boosts on top of that, as opposed to doing 6 double teams, getting 6 badge boosts special, and then using growth, getting rid of all those extra badge boosts, and giving our Pokemon the bog standard plus 6 stage special. Also, the badge boost doesn't care how many stages you're modifying a stat by, just that you're modifying it at all. Using Sword Stance will increase the defense stat by 12.5%. Using Meditate will increase the defense stat by 12.5%. And so if badge boosting is your aim, single stage modifiers like Meditate, Growth, and Harden can be more valuable than two stage options like Sword Stance, Acid Armor, and Agility, because you can get more uses out of them before hitting the plus 6 limit. It's worth noting that opponents are not affected by the badge boost glitch, as they have no badges. You'd think Gary would have some, but nope. Turns out he just snuck into the Indigo Plateau. As a final note, stats can also be modified by status conditions. Paralysis cuts speed, and Burn cuts attack. These stat cuts also work in a weird Gen 1 way with the badge boost glitch, but there's enough there to warrant its own video, so keep an eye out for that one. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, because I definitely did. If there's any game mechanics you'd like me to do an episode on, then please let me know. Next time, I'll be looking at stat experience and DVs. See ya!